Hello students, in today's session we are going to talk about rocket equation which is under law of conservation of linear momentum. Basically all of us know rocket is launched in space either to inject satellites at the specified positions or for the astronauts. Now let us look into this. What is the principle behind the rocket equation and what is the principle behind the launch of a rocket? As all of us know, law of conservation of linear momentum, the total momentum of a system in the absence of external force remains constant. So this is the basic principle behind the rocket propulsion. Here the technique used is called jet propulsion. Jet means a high velocity stream of fluid issuing through a nozzle. In the rocket, fuel is burnt in the combustion chamber. As a result, fast moving jet of gases escape from the tail of the rocket. They take some momentum in the downward direction. Before launching, as the total momentum of the system was zero, just to keep the total momentum, net momentum constant, the entire system moves up. They carry some momentum in the direction of escape. As a result, the rocket moves up in upward direction to keep the momentum constant. Here, as the gases escape from the rocket, mass of the rocket decreases continuously while the mass of the escaping gas increases, and therefore velocity of rocket also increases. So basically the principle used here is law of conservation of momentum. In short, whenever the burnt gases come down with tremendous velocity taking some momentum, to keep the momentum of the entire system constant, the rocket moves up. As the mass of the rocket goes on decreasing with the consumption of the fuel, the velocity goes on increasing. So even if the body is moving upwards, velocity goes on increasing. So this is the principle behind the design of a rocket or the launching of a rocket. Now let us have a mathematical touch to this particular rocket launch. Now let us consider the rocket with initial mass m naught when t equal to 0. Here the initial total mass of the rocket is made up of two parts, mass of the fuel mf and mass of the rocket mr. So total initial mass of the rocket before launching is m naught equal to mf plus mr. Now for our derivation, let us consider a unit vector in the upward direction. Let n cap be a unit vector in the upward direction and let u be the escape velocity of the gas with respect to the rocket, and let v be the velocity of the rocket with respect to the earth. So these are all the assumptions we have to make just to find out the final velocity of the rocket with which it is being launched. Now let us see, have some mathematical equations. Now velocity of the gas with respect to rocket is u, velocity of the rocket with respect to earth will be u plus v, net velocity, or u times minus n cap plus v times plus n cap. Here n cap is a unit vector in the upward direction, minus n cap is a unit vector in the downward direction. Therefore net velocity of the gas with respect to earth is v minus u into n cap. Now if m is the mass of the rocket at any instant, its instantaneous momentum is the product between mass and velocity, or it is m into v into n cap in vector notation. Therefore the rate of change of momentum of the rocket is d by dt of time derivative of momentum m into v into n cap. If you take this equation number 1, so this is how we estimate the rate of change of momentum of the rocket as it goes up. As it goes up, its velocity goes on increasing, momentum also goes on increasing. Therefore we can estimate its rate of change of momentum as d by dt of m into v into n cap. Let us take this equation as equation number 1. Now as I told you already, here dm by dt is the rate of change of mass of the rocket, which is negative. As the rocket mass of the rocket goes on decreasing as the fuel is consumed, dm by dt is negative. As a result, minus dm by dt is the rate of change of increase of the gas, which is positive because escaping gas amount of escaping gas goes on increasing. Therefore, minus dm by dt is positive. Therefore, we can find out rate of change of momentum of the gas as its rate of change of mass minus dm by dt into its velocity with respect to earth, v minus u times n cap. In short, rate of change of momentum of the gas is minus dm by dt into v minus u into n cap. As I told you already, rocket propulsion, rocket launching is based on law of conservation of linear momentum. If this much is the momentum changing in the downward direction, then equal and opposite momentum changes in the upward direction, which is connected to the rocket. Therefore, we can write rate of change of momentum of the rocket as minus of minus dm by dt, minus of rate of change of momentum of the gases, minus of minus dm by dt into v minus u into n cap. In other words, you can write it as dm by dt of v minus u into n cap. You can take this equation number 2. So, as per equation number 1, rate of change of momentum of the rocket, as per equation number 2 also, rate of change of momentum of the gas. Therefore, we can compare the two equations. Comparing the equation number 1 and 2, the equation boils down to d by dt of mv into n cap. This is equation number 1. And dm by dt of v minus u into n cap, equation number 2. Both are equal. Both are giving the rate of change of momentum of the rocket. Now, the left hand side, d by dt of the product, you can differentiate it, m times dv by dt plus v times dm by dt equal to v times, this is simple multiplication, dm by dt minus u times dm by dt. N cap cancels. Therefore, this is the final equation. Now, if you rearrange the terms and cancel the common terms on either side, v dm by dt cancels with this v dm by dt. Finally, you are left with m into dv by dt equal to e minus u into dm by dt. If you rearrange the terms, ultimately what you get is dv equal to minus u into dm by dt. Now, dv is minus u into dm by dt. Now you find the integration of this equation. Integrating the equation, what you get is v equal to minus u times log m to the base e plus c, where c is called constant of integration. You have to get rid of this constant of integration by applying boundary conditions. Therefore, ultimately, we can write down v equal to minus u into log m to the base e plus c. This is the intermediate equation. Rest of the topic we will consider in the next video. Thank you.